RSF factor, also known as the relative size theory. For the concept, I'll give you an example. I was working with KPMG for 2.5 years, and before KPMG, I used to work in a mid-sized firm in Mumbai. Over there, I met a very experienced and amazing chartered accountant, Mr. Vipul Gandhi, who is now around 60 years old. His data analytics was really amazing. While reviewing the financials, he used to check the variances between accounts and he used to call for specific printouts or specific ledgers, and he used to see it with great attention, and he used to circle few amounts and used to call for those invoices. Over here, Mr. Vipul Gandhi was looking for outliers, that is amounts that was out of contest or amounts that is of audit interest. Now, how do you locate outliers? This requires professional judgment. For example, let's take an amount of say 5 million. Is it a significant amount? Well, that depends on whose account you're looking at. If you're looking at Mr. Bill Gates' account, then an amount of 5 million is really very small. But if you're looking at my account, then an amount of 5 million is very huge. But the question is, how do you come to know in whose account which amount is significant? Well, it depends upon the other numbers in that account. Yes. For example, in my account, the amount that ranges are around 10,000 to 50,000. Yes, it is true. Well, so suddenly if there is an amount of 5 million in my account, it would be of audit interest. It would be an outlier. So let us see and understand about the RSF factor theory and how it is to be done in Excel. The data pertains to an educational trust who has started building new schools and colleges and has incurred huge capital cost. The data pertains to the capital purchase register. It contains date, name of the party, gross amount, taxes, net amount, and the sub-ledger account name. For RSF theory, for identifying the outlier, what we do is, we analyze the amounts of all the parties. We compare the amounts party-wise. We compare the biggest amount with the next biggest amount party-wise. That means I have to compare party-wise biggest amount with the next biggest amount. So let's see how we do it in Excel. We select the entire data, choose data tab and select sort. We choose name of the party with sort A to Z. Then add one more sort level. We sort the data net amount wise, biggest to smallest. Wow, we notice that the data has been sorted party wise and then amount wise. We type RSF in the cell to calculate the RSF factor. Then we divide the biggest amount with the next biggest amount. And here the RSF factor is calculated. We copy paste the formula for all the line items. Over here, we notice that the RSF factor has been calculated for all the parties. When the party changes, still the RSF factor is calculated. So what we do is, we tweak the formula a bit. We select the first cell, use F2 key and edit the formula. We use if condition. If the party equals the next party, then calculate RSF or else ignore. In inverted comma, we mention as ignore for false condition. We copy paste the formula till the end. Now we notice that for every change in the party, the RSF value is not calculated. Now what we do is, we check all the transactions where RSF value is more than 7. More than 7 would be considered as an outlier. We filter the RSF for more than 7. Over here, we notice that one item with an RSF value of 24. This needs attention. We color it yellow and remove the filter and locate it. We notice that
The highest amount is 1,44,000 and all the other amounts pertaining to that particular party is only 6,000. We need to check this amount. In reality, we actually stumbled upon two things. The invoice value was actually 14,400 and an extra zero was put by mistakenly. The second issue was that this was a customized software and the net amount was not calculated automatically but manually, as we can see it from the gross amount here.
So that was about the RSF factor. During our data analysis and audit, we have been able to identify many mistakes, control lapses and even fraud using the RSF theory. I hope you found this video quite helpful. Thank you.